Hi, welcome to How to Repair. I've been lucky enough this week to have been given by Ian a workshop manual on the Whirlpool 6 Sense washing machine, full error codes and diagnostic procedure. I'll be quickly talking you through each individual error code and also putting links in the description to relevant videos to assist you in repairing your machines. During the video, we will timestamp it so you can jump to the relevant error that you have on your machine. And also, if you do need parts for your washing machine, remember you will need the PNC number off your actual appliance. F0E5 error code. This can be caused by an imbalanced load. You may have problems with the spinning on the machine. Sometimes you may have a large amount of clothing building up on one side of the drum, like towels or large items, and this can cause an imbalanced load. F1E1, heating fault. This is usually due to either a faulty element, and you can test that. There are other videos in the description below, or you may have a problem with the connections between the element and the printed circuit board. Error code F3E2, usually due to a broken wire normally or a bad connection. You want to check the connections to and from the pressure switch, also on the pump side as well. Make sure you do a test on the pump and just follow the rest of the testing procedure that you can see on the screen here. F3E3 is another heating fault, but this time it's to do with the NTC sensor. Again, I will put a detailed video on how to test the NTC sensors in the description below. Check the wiring going to the NTC sensor from the circuit board, and also make sure that the NTC sensor is operating with the values that you can see on the screen here. You will need a multimeter to do this. F4E2 error code is to do with the heating system again, but this time they're suggesting it may be the NTC sensor or the wiring going from the circuit board to the NTC sensor, or you may have an earthing problem. You want to check the continuity on the wires going between the circuit board and the NTC sensor and make sure that the NTC sensor, as with the previous error code, is working correctly. And also, you may have a problem with the actual relay on the board itself. Error code F4E3, again, is to do with the heating system. Basic checks need to be done on the wiring, the element, and the circuit board connections. Also, make sure that you do an ohms reading test on the element and follow the procedures that you can see on the screen here. F4E4 is an actual another heating fault, and they're suggesting it's to do with the earth leakage on the element itself. So you will need to follow the previous checks that we went through on the other error codes. Error code F5E2 is a door lock fault or door wiring fault. It can also be the triac on the actual circuit board itself. Common faults that I've come across with these are burnt connections on the actual door lock. This has happened in the past. You want to make sure that you inspect the wiring, the door lock itself, and also all the connections. Error code F5E3 is indicating that you've got a door lock problem where the door is not opening. This could be because power is getting to the door lock when it shouldn't be, and this may be a fault with the circuit board. You want to check all the components around the connection point on the printed circuit board. You may also have a problem with the door interlock itself or problem with the wiring going from the door lock to the printed circuit board. Error code F6E1 is a communications fault. This is usually due to bad connections or a corrupted circuit board, either on the display board or on the main board. Error code F6E2 again is a communications problem. Just follow the instructions on the screen. I can't give you any further advice than bad connections or corrupted circuit board. As with the previous error codes, F6E3 error code is either communications fault in the cabling going between the boards, or it is a problem with the actual circuit board itself and it may be corrupted and need replacing. F7E1 error code is indicating that you've got a motor fault, PCB fault, or the wiring going through to the motor. It's suggesting that there's a tachometer fault on the motor. This is what counts the RPM of the motor sending the information to the circuit board. Error code F7E2 is indicating that you've got an MCU fault. It's telling you to do some basic tests on the motor. Check also the harness, or you may have a problem with the circuit board. Error code F7E8 is indicating that the motor is overheating. This could be because of overloaded drum, but I haven't come across it before. Just follow the steps on the screen that you can see here. Error code F7E9 is indicating that the motor's not moving, or motor fault as with the previous error codes. All I can actually suggest you do is bench test the motor separately off the machine to give you an idea if the motor is good. Error code F7EA is basically saying one of the fields of the motor, as it's a three-phase motor, is disconnected. All I can suggest you do is actually just do a test on the three phases of the motor, and also make sure that the wires going through the motor are in good condition. Error code F7EC. This is saying motor overload, as with one of the previous motor errors in the video. Again, check that you're not overloading the machine and just follow the checks for testing the motor. Error code F8E1 is basically saying the machine is unable to fill in the allocated period of time. Check your water supply going to the water valves on the washing machine. Also, make sure that when the machine's pushed back in, there's no kink in the pipe restricting the flow, and do your normal checks on the water valve. There's a video below to assist you in testing water valves. And also make sure the filter in the back of the water valve isn't got any debris in there restricting the flow of water. Error code F8E3, I'm not too sure what the manufacturer is meaning by overflow as the cause of fault here. They seem to be indicating two possible scenarios. One, the machine is filling when it shouldn't be. This could be a faulty water valve, letting water into the machine, or possibly the machine backfilling from a sink unit or something like that. But in another phrase, they're actually saying that the machine may not be draining with water, because they're saying replacing the pump. So I would do basic checks on the pressure switch, making sure no water is coming into the machine, and also making sure that the machine is draining correctly. Error code F8E6, their Whirlpool are calling it an aqua stop. It's actually an anti-flood device, which is usually in the bottom tray of the machine. Normally, this is activated and it will cut the machine off when water is getting into the base of the machine for safety purposes. You want to inspect things like any holes in the door seal, maybe a shaft on the pump leaking, or any other hoses that may be letting water to the bottom of the machine. Error code F9E1. Now, I'm not too sure what they're actually meaning here. Pressure switch emptying condition not reached. They're actually indicating two faults. So basically, I would be checking the pump system to make sure it's emptying in the allocated period of time. This could be due to a faulty pump, blockage in the system, especially in the sump hose. You want to make sure that there's no socks or anything else jammed in the sump hose, and make sure that the actual water is leaving the machine in the allocated period of time. They're also indicating that there may be a problem with the pressure switch. This can be tested, but basically, if the water is not emptying the machine in the allocated period of time, this may be the fault. Error code F9E2, pretty similar to a previous error code that came up. Again, check the pump is working correctly. Check the machine is emptying in the allocated period of time. They're also indicating that this fault may be to do with the aqua stop or the anti-flood device being activated. But basically, it's stating that the machine is not emptying in the allocated period of time. Error code FCE1, I have no experience with this whatsoever, but it's basically indicating a communication problem with the Wi-Fi module. These potential next three faults are to do with scenarios that may occur where they're not showing an error code on your display screen. Door is unlocking at the start of the cycle. This could be due to the child protection system or child lock system that is in place on the machine. Again, another error code that does not show in the display is the machine is switching off after a few seconds and not running through a cycle. They are instigating that you may have a problem with the pressure sensor, either not connected, faulty, or bad wiring. In the manual, they also say that the touch display will not show an error if it's not working. This could be because of a faulty display, bad wiring going through to the touch display, or possibly on previous experiences that I've had with these machines and other makes, is if the earth is not connected to the machine, you don't get a grounding. Therefore, it can't sense that you're actually touching the display. So I would check that as well. I hope you found this video helpful in diagnosing the problem with your machine, or at least pointing you in the right direction for working out what you need to have a look at. There's links in the description below, not only to Whirlpool parts, but to other videos that may assist you in repairing your appliance. Thanks very much indeed for watching. Remember to support the website by buying the parts off us, and if we really helped you, you can always click on the Buy Paul a Beer page. Thanks again for watching.